यस्मिन् सर्वं यथा सर्वं यः सर्वं सर्वतश्चयः यश्च सर्वमयो नित्यं तस्मै सर्वात्मने नमः। नमस्ते एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय लेक्चर ऑन कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ भावना विच इज एन एसेंशियल प्रोसेस इन आयुर्वेदिक फार्मास्यूटिक्स। आई एम टॉकिंग ऑन दिस टॉपिक as a part of educational material in Ayurveda network, which is being designed from Banaras Hindu University. I thank all those who are responsible for this program for giving me an opportunity, especially Dr. Kishore Patwardhan for giving this chance to interact with these people. So let me start with the sharing the side. My presentation is entitled as Role of Bhavana in Ayurveda Pharmaceutics. Bhavana is an essential pharmaceutical process in Ayurveda. We study this concept under paribhasha or glossary of technical terms in Rasa Shastra texts. However, this is not a process limited to Rasa Shastra. Entire Ayurveda pharmaceutics has given a unique place to this process, that is bhavana. Bhavana is also considered as a samskara in the texts like Charaka Samhita, with the help of which not only the potency of a drug can be altered, but it's also capable to bring about changes in characteristics of a drug, like say regulation, addition of new or deletion of undesirable characteristics. Let us begin with the classical definition of bhavana. The term bhavana is defined in Rasa Tarangini. We do also get a definition in Charaka Samhita in the commentary given by Acharya Chakrapani. Now first let us observe the definition given by Acharya Sadananda Sharma in Rasa Tarangini. He says, Yat churnitasya dhatvadehe dravaihi sampeshya shoshanam bhavanam tanmatam vijnaihi bhavana cha nigadhyate. Bhavana or in napunsakalinga bhavanam, both mean the same. Yat churnitasya dhatvadehe. Dhatvadehe means ores, minerals. So these are powder, that is the requirement. Churnitasya. Davaihi sampesya. And that powder is ground with liquids. Shoshanam and dried up. This entire process is known as bhavana or bhavanam. So we can say that bhavana is a process in which the material is completely submerged in prescribed liquid and triturated till its dryness. What are the objectives of bhavana? First is to bring minute particles of the material in contact with the liquid medium. When we grind the solid substance, it's divided into finer particles, and these particles will come in contact with the liquid that is added during bhavana process. Second is impregnation of properties of the media to the material. When we add a liquid, which may be a swarasa, the juice, or kashaya, the decoction, or Gomutra, or takra or kanjika, any liquid. The phytoconstituents that are present in it, trace minerals that are present in it, at different pH will impart these constituents to the material to which bhavana is given. So imparting of the properties of the media to the material is another important objective of bhavana. Third is transformation of the coarse powder to finer state. That is nothing but size reduction, which is definitely one of the important objectives of bhavana process. Fourth is to facilitate the material for further processing. In many of the pharmaceutical preparations, bhavana is an intermediate step. Bhavana may be done as a part of shodhana, or bhavana with specific medium is a part of marana process or preparation of bhasma. So during this process of bhavana, the materials are converted into finer particles, that is one. Sometimes there are some physico-chemical changes which are intermediate and helpful for further processing. Partial conversion into the formation of some chemical complexes will facilitate easy preparation of bhasma later. And also, during the process of bhasmikarana, after each puta, the chakrikas are broken and ground again with the liquid by the process of bhavana. During this process, unexposed particles will be exposed to the liquid medium and also to the heat later in the puta, resulting in proper physicochemical conversion. So to facilitate material for further processing also, bhavana is essential. Next is bhavana leads to unique and suitable physicochemical changes. Sixth objective is to potentiate the efficacy of the material. As we see in the case of Amalakya Rasayana, where the material is given repeated bhavana, its potency is enhanced. Required dosage to attain expected therapeutic action will be reduced. Now, next point is amount of liquid media. How much liquid you have to add when bhavana is to be carried out? We do find two different references for this. One reference is from Rasatarangini and the other one is from Sharangadhara Samhita. When you compare these two references, we feel that the reference given in Rasatarangini is suitable for rasadravyas or metallic or mineral preparations. Whereas the reference given in Sharangadhara Samhita is probably suitable for the herbal drugs. So this depends upon the definition given in Rasatarangini and also in Samhitas like Charaka Samhita. So let us understand these references. First one, Dravena Yavata Dravyam Churnitantu Ardratam Rajet Tavaneva Dravodeyo Bhishak Bhihi Bhavana Vitha. This is what Rasatarangini states. Dravena Yavata Dravyam Churnitantu Ardratam Rajet. Here, Churnitam Dravyam Tu Ardratam Rajet. That means you have to add the liquid in such a quantity that powder becomes wet. It absorbs the liquid, it becomes wet and can be made into a paste. So this should be the amount of liquid for bhavana purpose. So this is probably suitable for the definition given in Rasatarangini for bhavana, where It is mentioned yat churnitasya dhatvadehi dravaihi sampeshya peshanam. You are doing a process of grinding here till dryness. Now let us see the other reference. Dravena yavata samyak churnam sarvam plutam bhavet bhavanayah pramanantu churne proktaha bhishakvarehi. In the context of Churna Kalpana in Madhyama Khanda, Acharya Sharangadhara has quoted this. He says, Dravena Yavata Samyak Chudam Sarvam Plutam Bharat. That means powder should be submerged in the liquid. The quantity of the liquid should be such that it covers the powder, or powder remains sunken or submerged inside the liquid. So that should be the amount of liquid added for bhavana purpose. If you see the reference of Charaka Samhita, where Chakrapani has commented, he says, Diva divatape shoshanam nishichasthaparam iti, where you have to take a herbal powder to which liquid is added and kept under sunlight in daytime or kept as it is overnight till it dries up. Here grinding is not mentioned. Probably for such herbal drugs, the quantity of liquid may be slightly high, which can completely cover the powder. Then you can keep it under sunlight or as it is till it dries up. So we do get two references here regarding the amount of liquid medium that is to be used for bhavana purpose. To clarify these references, I am giving you point by point. First, the amount of the liquid may be gravimetrically equal to the quantity of the material to be levigated, or it may be volumetrically so much that the material can be immersed completely, or it may be volumetrically so much that the material can be made into dough, or amount of liquid media should be taken so much that it can make the material wet throughout the specific period of grinding. Sometimes time period is mentioned for grinding, say 1 yama, 2 yama, 1 day, 7 days, like that. So accordingly the quantity of the liquid may have to be altered. So these are four different possibilities regarding the amount of liquid media to be used for bhavana purpose. Now let us see about the procedure. Before going to the procedure, one important standard operative procedure related to kwatha is to be understood here. When kashaya is to be used for bhavana purpose, then how it has to be prepared? It's slightly different than the general method of preparation of kashaya as described by Rasakarani. It states, भाव्य द्रव्य मितः क्वाथ्यो जलम अष्टगुणं ततः वस्वंश शोषितः क्वाथो देयः क्वाथेन भावने. वस्तु अंश, वी नो दैट अकॉर्डिंग टू हिंदू माइथोलॉजी देर आर अष्ट वसु. तो वसु अंश मीन्स यर वन एट. यू हैव टू ऐड 8 times ऑफ वाटर टू द ड्रग. Boil it till you reduce it to 1/8. There is a slight difference here regarding the avashesha than the general method of preparation of kashaya. So I repeat, so in case where the media is taken as decoction, the amount of dry herb should be taken equal to the amount of material, that is first. Then 8 times water should be added to it and should be reduced to 1/8 by boiling. to continue SOP or procedure. Then the decoction is added to the material as much that the material remains wet for whole day or throughout grinding process. So this process is continued for 7 days in general until and unless it is mentioned. So this is one of the opinions. The material is mixed with liquid and grinding is continued as the material becomes dough, and continue it either for a specific period mentioned or till dryness or till you get Subhavita Lakshana, the features of perfect bhavana. So let us see what are these. What are the chief desired characters? To simplify, 3 points are mentioned here. First, desired shape can be given to the material after levigation. Second, if you press the dough-like material with the finger, it will turn into a flat shape and also it will be soft to touch. Now let us see what the classics is. In the commentary of Rasatarangini, it is mentioned what are the Subhavita Lakshana and what are the Durbhavita Lakshana. That means, how do you confirm that bhavana is proper and how will you say that bhavana is incomplete? For Subhavita Lakshana, it is said, Peshamanancha Yadravyam Chipiti Bhuya Churatam Yati Mardava Yuktam Tat Subhavitam Udahratam. Peshamanancha Yadravyam, the drug that is being ground. Chipiti Bhuya, then Churanatam. First I will take Chipiti Bhuya. That means the drug which is being ground, which is still in semi-solid state, if you press, it becomes flat like a disc. And important here is, when you press it, the disc formed should have an entire margin, without any disruption, without any breakage. This smooth margin indicates fineness of the particles that is attained. Churanaka, when it becomes powder, yati mardavayuktam, if you rub between the fingers, it will be soft and smooth. Then we call it as subhavita, or bhavana is done properly. For Durbhavita Lakshana, it is mentioned like this. Yat pishtam sahasa dirnam karasparsham nakomalam tat durbhavitam iti uktam bhavana vedi bhi janaihi. What the experts of bhavana mention is like this. Karasparsham, it is rough to touch. The material will be rough to touch. Na komalam, it is not soft. Yat pishtam sahasa dirnam, here dirnam means broken. Here, when you press the material which is still in semi-solid state, it may become flat, but you will see that the margin is broken, disrupted. This is because of larger particle size. So the disrupted margin of the disc, hard and rough to touch, are the characters of Durbhavita material. In such situation, you will have to continue levigation till you get Subhavita Lakshana. Now let us see what is the role of media here. Liquid medium that you add facilitates easy grinding and smooth grinding. Of course, when liquid is added naturally, dust is prevented. Powder will not escape in the form of dust. And in the process of grinding, minute particles of the material will come into the liquid medium and interact. If at all you are going to prepare a bhasma, pellets can be prepared after proper levigation. So it helps in further processing. Here liquid binds the material and it helps us to change the shape into a flat disc that is required for putta. Media that is used here impregnates its active principles to the material and makes the material organic. It's essential for us to convert inorganic material into organo-inorganic complex so that its bioavailability and therapeutic efficacy will increase. Liquid medium acts as a binding agent also, as I already mentioned. So this helps us to prepare pills, if at all you are preparing any kalviya rasayana, and also it helps us to prepare discs or chakrikas. And apart from this, every bhavana dravya that is used for grinding contains lots of trace elements in it, maybe metallic or non-metallic trace elements. So these inorganic contents will be transferred to the bhasma that is produced later, and they will supply the required trace elements to the body. So particular medium that is mentioned for levigation of a specific material indicates some basic relation between the medium and the specific material many a times. So judicially, such medium is selected. It may enhance safety, it may enhance bioavailability and efficacy also. What are the changes that we are expecting during bhavana process? First is the physical changes. Under physical changes, first point is reduction in hardness. When you grind the material continuously with the liquid, naturally a hard material becomes soft in its consistence. The second physical change occurring is increase in the weight. The organic and inorganic content of the media are added up to the material to which bhavana is given, because of which weight of the material will increase. The third is particle size reduction. By continued attrition, a friction, there will be reduction in the particle size progressively as bhavana process is continued. Fourth is binding agent. Liquid used acts as a binding agent. It binds the particles together, which helps in the preparation of pills or chakrika. This is also a physical change. Trace element supplement. So there may not be any chemical interaction here. Physically, trace elements that are present in the media are added up to the drug. So in bhasma preparation, the organic components are burnt, but the inorganic contents, they get transferred into the bhasma and they supply the trace elements. That's about the physical changes. What are the chemical changes that we can expect? First is a possible chemical reaction. So during levigation, finer particles of the material that come in contact with the liquid medium will have a type of chemical reaction for which heat generated during the process also helps. So there is always a possibility of occurrence of a chemical reaction. For this grinding action, heat generated, pH of the liquid, so like many factors may play their own role. Second possibility here is formation of desired compound, of course as a result of this chemical reaction. So in Marana process, that is when we prepare bhasma, metals and minerals, they are mixed with the drug for incineration and thereafter levigation is done by liquid media. So this liquid media during the process of grinding may cause some chemical reaction. For example, in the case of Rajata Bhasma, it is found that the medium that is used, Gandhaka, in the process, when ground with specific liquid, will help to form an intermediate compound, silver sulfide, Ag2S. So this helps for us to get same compound in the final product in bhasma also. Here during bhavana, of course, entire material is not converted, but formation of compounds begins during the process of bhavana itself. So this is a possible chemical reaction. Third changes that we can expect are the biological changes. When particle size is reduced, naturally its absorption and bioavailability will be enhanced. Induction of trace elements also will help to fulfill our bodily requirement of trace elements. So this aids a number of physiological processes in the body. Formation of desired compounds during the bhavana process also increases the therapeutic efficacy, because we know that except gold, probably all other metals form their compounds, maybe sulfides or oxides. The formation of such compounds many a times will enhance their bioavailability and therapeutic efficacy. And these compounds, they interact with organic materials and form complexes also. So these organic and inorganic complexes further improve the therapeutic efficacy of the material. So as I said, organometallic or organomineral type of compounds are produced here that are favorable to the body. If we observe this reference given in Charaka Samhita carefully, it clearly mentions that bhavana enhances bioavailability, it also improves therapeutic potency. Acharya has quoted the example of amalaki rasayana. Amalaki rasayana is a product which is prepared by giving bhavana of amalaki swarasa to amalaki churna. 21 such bhavanas are to be given. Gangadhara, commenting on the statement of Charaka Samhita, mentions bhavanadibhi gunaha adhiyante dravyanam dravena alodanat diva divatape shushanam nishisthapanam ityevam vidhanam bhavana taya gunantaradhanam syat. Similar is the opinion of Chakrapani also, which I have already mentioned. Dravyanam dravena alodanat, drugs are mixed with the liquid दिवा दिवातपे शोषणम् ड्राइड अंडर सनलाइट डे टाइम और केप्ट एज इट इज एंड अलाउड टू ड्राई एट नाइट सो दैट इंटरैक्शन विल कंटिन्यू सो दिस रिजल्ट्स इन गुणांतराधानम् सो आई एम मेंशनिंग ऑल द प्रोसेसेस फॉर गुणांतराधान अंडर संस्कार चरक संहिता स्टेट्स संस्कारो हि गुणांतराधानम् उच्यते ते गुणाः तोयाग्निसन्निकर्ष शौच मंथन देश काल वासना भावनादिभिः काल प्रकर्ष भाजनादिभिश्च आधीयन्ते सो भावना इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोसेस टू ब्रिंग अबाउट गुणांतर आधार सो इट इज राइटली सेड इन कल्पस्थान 12th चैप्टर दैट भूयश्चैषां बलाधानं कार्यं स्वरसभावनैः सुभावितं हि अल्पोपि द्रव्यं स्यात् बहुकर्मकृत् सो स्वरसैः तुल्यवीर्येण वा तस्मात् द्रव्याणि भावयेत् बाय गिविंग द भावना ऑफ स्वरस ऑफ द सेम ड्रग इट्स पोटेंसी कैन बी एनहांस्ड बाय सेवरल फोल्ड्स सुभावितं हि इफ प्रॉपर भावना इज गिवन अल्पोपि द्रव्यं स्यात् even when the dose of the drug is small bahu karma krit it will show an enhanced therapeutic efficacy so swarasaihi by using its own juice or tulya virya irva using the drugs of similar virya bhavana has to be given now let us discuss this entire concept of bhavana with light of modern physics and also chemistry. First point that we will have to address here is the importance of particle size reduction. It has been well established that solubility of a substance can be increased by increasing the dissolution rate that may be accomplished either by particle size reduction or modifying crystal habit. It's very essential for us to see that bioavailability of a product is enhanced. If bioavailability is to be enhanced, the drug should be better soluble in body fluids. To improve this solubility, we require particle size reduction, or you may have to change the crystal habit of the particles. And this can be achieved to a great extent by bhavana. Furthermore, solubility increases by increasing the surface area available for solvation. During bhavana, the particles are made into fine and finer. So naturally, you will have more surface area that are exposed to the liquid. Because of this, solubility increases. So particle size reduction technology is a safe method to increase the solubility of substances without altering the chemical nature of the drug. And it can routinely be used to increase the bioavailability of those drugs that are poorly soluble. Further, as I said, it's a well-established fact that particle size is an important factor that is accountable for solubility and bioavailability of the drugs. It is found that when the particle size is less than 1 millimeter, it causes a disruption of a solute-solute interaction. And also, it increases the solvation pressure and affects the kinetic solubility. Because of this, dissolution will be eased and this increases the solubility significantly. There is an important role of mardana here or grinding. Mechanical energy which is originated due to the process of grinding is responsible for breaking the order of the structure. And also this mechanical energy produces cracks. And these cracks are produced at the point of impact of the edges, the solid deform. So when we grind, when there is an attrition, at the point of impact of the edges of the solids which deforms, so these cracks are produced. Because of the production of the cracks, new surfaces are exposed. Further, this grinding will help us to form hot points. And where these are formed? So these hot points are formed where the molecules can reach very high vibrational excitation, leading to bond breaking. And ultimately, small particles are generated. So at the area of attrition, such hot points are produced where you will see that molecules reach a very high level of vibrational energy. They will excite and they will have vibrational energy to a great extent, because of which there will be bond breakage, so that small particles are generated. So these are the things that are happening because of mechanical action during grinding process. And this grinding operation mainly involves two major processes. They are pulp flow and stress application. And both pulp flow and stress application are happening simultaneously during the process of grinding. So these processes include transport of material to the grinding zone and subjecting to the grinding actions, leading to possible propagation and initiation of cracks. During the process of grinding, when the materials are fed to the grinding zone, so they are ground. So then cracks will be initiated. The breakage of a particle can be achieved if the particle is captured in the grinding zone. Otherwise, it is not possible. So we will have to regularly feed the material to the grinding zone, because of which you can expect fruitful breaking action. If you are talking about a pulp flow process, that is the transport of material inside a mill, it largely depends on the pulp fluidity. And this is influenced by the state of aggregation or dispersion of particles, how the particles aggregate and disperse inside the mill. And it is further determined by the nature of interactions between the particles and the grinding media. That is very important. How the particles interact with the grinding media and how the particles aggregate and disperse inside the mill. So in the bhavana process, as we add a small quantity of the liquid, this liquid that is added may change the pulp fluidity, which ultimately helps in particle size reduction. When the second mechanism, stress application process, is considered, size reduction of the solids is achieved by subjecting particles to different stresses. And these stresses involve rupturing of chemical bonds to create new surfaces. And also they will retard rejoining of the ruptured surface. In the process of bhavana, you will see that breaking of solid particles, subjecting to particle stresses in grinding zone, is responsible for initiation and propagation of cracks. And this leads to numerous fractures in each particle, which is very, very essential. So these fractures that are occurring within the particle itself, that is intragranular fracture, or occurring along with the grain boundaries, that is intergranular fracture, are quite important. Intragranular fracture is sufficient for size reduction, whereas intergranular fracture is important for liberation. Further, it has been well understood and well established that all natural materials have some defects in them. And these defects may be in the form of cracks, flaws, or dislocations. And these defects will act as stress modifiers, and that leads to the decreasing strength of the particle, so that particle gets disrupted easily. So it has been supposed that liquids such as water or any liquid for that matter plays a very important part in bhavana process, and adding surface active agents could further amplify this process. Now let us further try to validate the concept of bhavana with some more principles. Very important observation is that bhavana, or which can be roughly translated as revigation, rather than using the term trituration, I prefer using the term levigation, it generates nanoparticles. Bioavailability enhancement of partially water-soluble solid medicament in the traditional system of medicine happens by bhavana. So this is well established. It was found that particle reduction technology is improving solubility. It's enhancing bioavailability, and many such particle reduction technologies used in Ayurveda, apart from bhavana, like bhasmikarana, churnikarana, etc., might correspond to liquid-assisted grinding, especially the process of bhavana, where liquid is essential. So this liquid-assisted grinding and trigonochemistry is something which is observed in physical chemistry, and that can be correlated with our mechanism of bhava. As I already mentioned, particle size which is lower than 1 millimeter causes a disruption of solute-solute interaction and improves bioavailability. We can compare and correlate bhavana, marana and tribochemistry, most probably. The reaction of solid state components by liquid assisted grinding is also an important method that is responsible for the conversion of inert precursors such as metal oxides into hybrid inorganic organic materials. You will see the metal oxides that are present in the substance. When you go for the process of bhavana, that will help to convert such inert precursors to easily bioavailable inorganic organic hybrid complexes. In Putta system, purified material when subjected for grinding after adding small amount of the liquid, when the process is completed, we are subjecting it to ignition at a high temperature or at a specific quantum of heat that is mentioned. So this entire process is a likeness to trigonochemistry in contemporary science, because here it is the coupling of mechanical and chemical phenomena at atomic and molecular scale, which includes mechanical breakage, chemical behavior of mechanically stressed solids. And same things are happening in bhavana marana and also in trigonochemistry. The chemistry that occurs between the lubricant and environment with the rubbing surfaces under boundary lubrication conditions is known as trigonochemistry. So this is a chemical interaction that is happening between the environment and the lubricant during the process of rubbing or grinding or attrition, and also under the boundary lubrication condition. So this is the tribochemistry. Further, this includes specific reactions that occur only during rubbing and chemical interaction with the surface, like say oxidation, thermal degradation, catalysis, and polymerization. So these are the possible chemical interactions that we can expect, which is preceded with some physical activities like rubbing. Further, there are two possible sources of tribochemistry here. One is the mechanically induced chemistry, where there will be fresh nascent surface and electron emission. And second one is the thermally induced chemistry at the aspirate tips due to flash temperatures, which is happening in Marana process. In mechanically induced chemistry, which is more important for us under the heading of Bhavana, energy required to activate chemical reactions and structural changes comes from mechanical process. So bioavailability of fewer water-soluble solid medicaments is found to get enhanced effectively, not only in ancient science, also in contemporary science, when the application of particle reduction technology is done. The particle reduction technology of ancient science may be in the form of bhavana, mardana, churikarana, bhasmikarana, etc. And that may correspond to modern days liquid assisted grinding, tribochemistry, mechanochemistry, etc. respectively. So in parallels with this, we can try to understand our science very well as newer researches are being conducted, as more and more mechanization is done, as there is an advancement in the field of physics, chemistry, nanotechnology, biochemistry, molecular biology, biotechnology, etc. We are able to understand the science behind our concept in a better and better form. So besides particle size reductions by ancient technology, bioavailability could also be enhanced, which is very important therapeutically. So these discussions in relation with the tribochemistry are the contributions of the respected Dr. Anand Chaudhary, along with his co-authors K.D. Yadav and A.K. Verma, submitted and published in their article entitled Bioavailability Enhancement of Partially Water-Soluble Solid Medicament in Traditional System of Medicine, published in Indian Journal of Pharmacological Science in 2017. This process by which bhavana enhances bioavailability is probably by these three mechanisms: reduction in particle size, formation of nano emulsion, and formation of biological complexes. So finally, let us find a couple of scientific evidences which support us why bhavana process is very much essential. So this is a study carried out by Sumita L. under the guidance of Professor Dr. Gudaganati sir and Dr. B.S. Prasad. And they have published it in International Journal of Ayurvedic Medicine in 2014. Title of the article is Effect of Bhavana Samskara on Particle Size Distribution in Various Stages of Preparation of Niruha Basti, with special reference to Matha Tailika Basti. In this study, they have clearly mentioned that as the process of bhavana is continued, particle size is progressively reduced. In Niruha Basti, as we know very well, there is a sequential mixing that is mentioned, like Lakshikam, Lavanam, Sneham, Kalkam, Kvatham, Kramat. Authors say that at the end of mixing in 30 minutes, in each step, homogeneity in distribution of particles could be achieved, and also reduction in particle size could be found. They found that about 90% of the particles were below the size of 0.010 microns. That means less than 10 nanometers. So these data indicate that drugs are more microfined as the number and duration of bhavana increase. In this picture you can see, after 5 minutes of levigation between Makshika and Lavana in the first phase of grinding in the Niruha Dravya Vyamishrana, the particle size are larger. After 15 minutes, after 25 minutes and after 30 minutes, you can see how the particles are becoming smaller and smaller, finer and finer. At the end of 30 minutes, even nanoparticles could be generated. There is another study which speaks about influence of bhavana on pharmacognostical parameters of amalaki rasayana vis-a-vis amalaki churna or amalaki powder. The powder microscopy shows thickened epidermal cells in amalaki powder, which got disturbed after bhavana in amalaki rasayana. Similarly, mesocarp cells seen in amalaki powder also got ruptured after bhavana. Further, the authors say that even the fibers entangled with scleroids got free from them and found separately in amalaki rasayana. So these changes suggest that as a result of bhavana, the intracellular content that are locked inside the cells, inside the cellular compartment, they are freed, and this might result in increased bioavailability and better therapeutic efficacy. The study was carried out by Laik S., Dr. Anup Thakur, Rudrappa, H.C. and others, and they published it in International Journal of Green Pharmacy under the title Influence of Bhavana on Pharmacognostical Parameters of Amalaki Rasayana vis-a-vis Amalaki Powder. There is another study carried out on Shwasa Kuthara Rasa. Here of course it is the Mardana that is done, not exactly the Bhavana, but it's a part of bhavana itself where size reduction is considered. Title of this study is Effect of Nano Sizing on Bioefficacy of Shwasa Kuthara Rasa, a Herbo Mineral Formulation for Asthma and Allergy. It's published by Suresh Janadri et al. It was published in 2011. And they mentioned that the objective of the study was to assess the effect of nano sizing on bioefficacy of Shwasa Kuthara Rasa, a herbal mineral formulation, in albino rats with the target to the disease asthma and also allergic conditions. Here, Shwasa Kuthara Rasa was selected and it was nano sized. They took the help of a planetary micromill, P7, and they milled it to generate micro and nanoparticles. And then they carried out experimental study, especially anti-asthma and anti-allergic activities were evaluated by using albino rats. The model used was clonidin-induced mast cell degranulation and catalepsy. The outcome of the study says that there was significant percentage protection of mast cells, say 44.13% found in Shwasa Kuthara Rasa, which was milled to generate microfine and nanofine particles, when compared to the control group where 27.16% protection of mast cell was observed and the control group had plain Schwarzkopf-Ahrens. So this confirms that size reduction of Schwarzkopf-Ahrens offered better or more significant protection on mast cell degranulation and catalepsy in rats. And it was confirmed that the efficacy was fineness dependent. That is, smaller the particle size, better the anti-asthmatic and anti-allergic effect were observed. So this further supports our classical concept of Mardana and Bhavana. In one more study carried out by Yogesh Yam and others on the effect of Bhavana Samskara on phytopharmacognostical evaluation in relation to Harita Kichurna, they say that they could find considerable changes in the phytopharmacognostical levels. Exactly what type of changes that are observed could not be further elicited. Some basic information is available in this particular article. However, this requires more study to find out the applicability of such changes that are observed. But there is no doubt that Bhavana process certainly brings about changes in phytopharmacognostical properties of Haritaki Churna. So in our institute, in Munyal Institute of Ayurveda Medical Sciences, in a couple of studies, we could really found the importance of Bhavana. One of the study carried out by Dr. Sajana on Dhatri Loha has indicated that amount of gallic acid increases as the number of Bhavana is increased. We know that while preparing Dhatri Loha, we have to give Bhavana with Guduchi Swarasa. We evaluated Dhatri Loha samples at different numbers of Bhavana, after 3 Bhavanas, 5 Bhavanas, and after complete 7 Bhavanas like that. We could see that amount of gallic acid is progressively increasing as the Bhavana numbers are increased and also particle size is progressively decreasing. So this is at the pharmaceutical and analytical level. Certainly we can further support this finding at pharmacological and clinical levels also. One more such study was carried out by Dr. Neeraj Jaiswal, who worked on the Chaushastik Prahari Pippal. He evaluated plain Pippali Churna and compared it with Chaushastik Prahari Pippali, where Pippali Churna is given the Bhavana of Pippali Kashaya for 64 Praharas, that is 64 into 3 hours, say about 8 days. He could see there is a variation in the piperine content. He found that amount of piperine got progressively increased as Bhavana is continued, and also particle size is progressively decreasing as the Bhavana is continued. So these studies clearly show the impact, role and importance of Bhavana in the pharmaceutical process. So with this information, let me conclude the session. Bhavana is a process that is comparable with navigation and it has very important role to play in Ayurvedic pharmaceutics. Particle size reduction, binding, detoxification, potentiation and increase in bioavailability are the important contributions of Bhavana. Mechanization is the present day requirement for effectively adopting classical Bhavana process. We may make use of wet grinders, end runner mill, edge runner or other mechanized kalavayantra can be used to achieve the Bhavana that is mentioned in the classics as a part of standard operative procedure. If you want to get same to and fro motion which is seen in manual type of Bhavana, Such type of mechanical kalvayantra are available where a pestle is connected to a motor. You can have same type of bhavana process, but see that materials are fed repeatedly to the track of grinding. With this, so let me conclude the session. These are a few of the references that I had gone through while preparing this lecture. I once again thank all of you for your patient listening, and my special thanks to all the members of Ayurveda Network, and my congratulations to all those who are involved in developing this type of educational platform by the name of Ayurveda Network. Once again, thanking you. Let me conclude here. See you again soon. Thank you so much for joining me.